Today, we are going to talk about all the security related features for Azure Disk Storage that you can leverage to get the best security in the cloud. So before we talk about security, let's first understand what are the benefits of using Azure Disk Storage. Azure Disk Storage is the block storage that you attach to an IS virtual machine in Azure. Azure Disk is the fastest disk in the cloud. You can use a single Ultra Disk to get 160,000 IOPS and 2 Gbps bandwidth. Azure Disk provides 0% annual failure rate, meaning that Azure Disk till now hasn't lost any data for any customer. Azure Disk provides 99.9% single VM SLA. This is the highest SLA possible in the cloud. This SLA comes with money back guarantee, which allows you to host your mission critical workload with high confidence in Azure. Our Ultra Disk offering provides the flexibility to scale IOPS and bandwidth up and down. So whenever you need more IOPS, more bandwidth, you can simply update the system to get more IOPS and bandwidth. And when you don't need, during off hours, you can bring down the IOPS and bandwidth, reducing your cost. Now let's look at different disk types that you can use. So in this table, when you go from left to right, meaning from standard SDD to Ultra Disk, the performance increases. You will get more IOPS, you will get more bandwidth, whereas the latency reduces as you go from left to right. Now, let's talk about the security-related features. So by default, all managed disks, they are encrypted with a platform managed key at rest. And you also have a choice of using your own key that you can bring it to bring from on-premises and upload it to Azure keyboard, or you can generate a new key in the keyboard, and then you can use that key to encrypt your managed disk or snapshot or images. Now, typically, we see that customers use a single key to encrypt many resources. And to make your life simpler, we have introduced this new resource called disk encryption set. So you create an instance of disk encryption set and associate it with a key. And then you can associate all the disks that you want to encrypt with the same key to an instance of disk encryption set. Now, recently, we introduced another feature. It's called double encryption at rest. And this feature is very useful for high security sensitive customers who are worried that a particular encryption algorithm or their key can be compromised. And to solve their problem, we encrypt the data twice, one time with the key that you have provided, and another time with a key managed by Microsoft, with a platform managed key. And then we use two different algorithms. And even if one algorithm is compromised, your data cannot be accessed because it is still encrypted with another algorithm. Now let's talk about how server-side encryption works. And the first thing to understand is envelope encryption that we use under the hood. So when you enable server-side encryption with custom managed keys for your managed disk, under the hood, we generate a data encryption key. And then the system sends that data encryption key to the keyboard. And then the data encryption key is encrypted with the key that you have provided in the keyboard. And then the encrypted data encryption key is stored in the system. And whenever a new write, a new read comes to the system again sends back the encrypted data encryption key to the keyboard and then gets the data encryption key decrypted. And then caches the data encryption key, the decrypted data encryption key in the memory for a short period of time, and then uses it for encrypting and decrypting data. And when the cache expires, it again goes back to the keyboard to get the data encryption key decrypted. So with this concept, let's understand the end-to-end workflow, like how things work under the hood, and how we provide you more control with this feature. So the first step in the workflow is an admin user who will create an instance of this encryption set by associating it with a key in the keyboard. And then under the hood, right, as soon as the disk encryption set is created, the system creates an identity for the disk encryption set in the Azure Active Directory. And then the admin user is responsible to use that identity to provide access to the key in the keyboard. And after that, a VM user who's responsible for creating manifestors will associate the instance of this encryption set with the manifestors and then encrypt the manifestors with customer manifest key. Now, the admin user can also enforce at the subscription level or at the Uber account level, they can enforce that all manifestors should be encrypted by associating with a disk encryption set. Basically, mandate that all data should be encrypted with customer manifest keys. So that is also possible through Azure policy integration. And then once the manifestors is encrypted, then you're good to go. Now, as soon as new writes or new reads come to manifestors, manifestors will go and talk to the Azure Active Directory. Using the identity of the disk encryption set, it will basically first authenticate itself by providing that identity. And then it will use that identity to get the data encryption key decrypted. So now this handshake between manifestors and Azure Active Directory and handshake between manifestors and Azure Keyboard is very important because this mechanism allows you to be in full control. At any point in time, you can simply revoke the access in the Azure Keyboard, and then manifestors won't be able to access the data. And you can also simply delete the identity in your Azure Active Directory, and then manifestors won't be able to access the data, or nobody can access the data, right? So that is how you are in full control of your key and of your data. Now let's talk about another important scenario that you want to enable with this feature is key rotation. So you have to do key rotation at regular intervals to meet your compliance need, or you have to do key rotation to meet your security needs. And key rotation is as simple as updating a disk encryption set with a new key or a new version of the same key. And as soon as you update the disk encryption set, all the resources which are referencing that disk encryption set will be automatically updated to use the new key. So this is the key rotation for you. Now let's talk about another important feature that we have introduced recently. It's called as encryption at host. So whenever you create a virtual machine, you also store some data on the VM host side. VM host is the cluster where your virtual machine is created or hosted. And you can store data on dem disk, and behind the scene, that data is stored on the VM host. Or if you have enabled cache for your OS or data disk, that cache is stored behind the scene on the VM host. Or like the data in transit, which travels from VM host to the backend storage. Now, all this data you can encrypt by setting a new property called encryption at host to true. So this is another important feature to look at. And the cache and data in transit inherits the key from the parent OS and data disk, but the temp disk is always encrypted with platform managed key. So now in this case, the parent disk is encrypted with custom managed keys. So that is why the cache and data in transit will be encrypted with custom managed keys, but temp disk is always encrypted with platform managed key. And you can go and look at this link to know more information about this feature. Now, let's go and look at this feature in action. Okay, now let's go and check it out, different encryption types that you can enable for your Azure Disk Storage. So let's go to the resource group. And the first step in enabling encryption with custom managed keys is to create an instance of this encryption set. So you can click the Add button, and then let's go and then create a disk encryption set. And I want to do it in West US 2 because I have already created a keyboard in that region. So let's give it a name. And now here you have the option of selecting either a single layer of encryption with customized keys or double encryption. So let's go with the first option. And now let's go and select a key from the keyboard. I've already created a keyboard and also a key. So I'm going to simply select that. And then you're good to go. So now let's go and hit the create button and you should be good to go. Now we'll wait for this disk encryption set to be created. And if you remember, we have to perform one action, which is after the disk encryption set is created, as an admin user, I have to grant permission to the instance, to the keyboard. It's not done automatically because it's very important in terms of security that a person, right, who has required permission in the keyboard comes and explicitly does this operation. So we'll go to the disk encryption set, and then portal makes it very easy. It's just telling you that, hey, you haven't set up the permission. So you click this ribbon and then you're good to go. So now we are good to go for encrypting Azure Disk Storage with using disk encryption set. Now let's go back to the resource group and now let's try to add a virtual machine. So let's select this operating system. And again, we'll select the region as West US2. Now simply let's go to the disk tab. And you will see that by default, the OS disk type is encrypted with platform managed key. And then you can select between the two other options, which is single layer of encryption with custom managed keys and double encryption. So let's select this one. And if you select custom managed key, then you have to select a disk encryption set. So we'll select this one that we previously created. And let's select this one. And you're good to go. Now the OS disk will be encrypted with custom managed key using the key that is associated with this disk encryption set. Now, if you want to also encrypt the data stored on the temp disk, cache, and data in transit, you can simply select this option to yes, and you're good. Now you have encrypted all the different data that you're storing on the VM host and also backend storage using custom managed key. Okay, now let's talk about another important feature. So you might be already familiar with Azure Private Links, which is already available for many Azure resources, such as storage accounts, such as Azure databases, such as virtual machine. And now we are simply including the export and import of managed disk in the umbrella. So this feature allows you to restrict the export and import of managed disk only from your secured private network. And then the private links, they are already come inbuilt with data exfiltration protection, meaning that a rogue employee cannot download the underlying data of managed disk to their storage account or to a virtual machine, right? Because they can download data only to the trusted virtual machine, only to the trusted storage account that are part of this private network, right? So that is another advantage of using private links for exporting and importing managed disk. Another important thing is that when you download the data of your managed disk from a virtual machine in your secured network, the connection between the virtual machine and then the backend storage goes over Azure private network. It never crosses over to public network. So that is another benefit of using private links. And to use this feature, you have to use the new resource type called as disk access. So you will create an instance of disk access and then associate disk access to your private virtual network in Azure through private links. And then you can associate disk access object to any disk that you want to secure. That basically, you can associate disk access to all the disks, snapshot, and images that you want to secure, like basically you want to secure the export and importing of these resources. So that's it. So now again, let's go and check out the feature in action. Now let's look at private links in action. As I mentioned before, the first step is to create a disk access object. So I have already created a disk access object, and let's go and explore it. If you go under private endpoint connection, you can see that it is associated with a private endpoint. And if you go to the private endpoint, you will see that it is associated to a VNet and subnet. Now, once you associate disk access to a snapshot or to a managed disk, you will be able to export or import a disk or export a snapshot only from this, only from a VM inside the subnet. So let's go and then see how it works. So I have already created a snapshot, and what we are going to do, we are going to associate the snapshot to the disk access object that we have already created. So you can go to the networking tab, and then here you can select private endpoint, and now you'll be asked to enter or select a disk access that we have already created. That's it. And one thing is that, like, we also provide this option called deny all, wherein if you don't want anybody to export the data or import the data, you can simply turn it, you can simply select this option, deny all, and that's it. Now, nobody will be able to generate a SAS URI that is used for exporting or importing the data. Right now, let's check out private endpoint. So now we selected this option, click on save, and then it will take a few seconds to save, and that's it. Now let's go and try to export the underlying VSD file of the snapshot. Now the thing is, right now I'm using my laptop, which is certainly not part of the secured VNet to which the disk access is associated to. Right, so I should not be able to download the underlying VSD file of the snapshot. So now if I click this, I should get an error. See that the error that I'm getting, this request is not authorized, certainly because I'm trying to download from my personal laptop, which should not be allowed. Now let's go and try to do the same thing from a virtual machine, which is part of the same VNet. So if I go back to the snapshot, and if I go to this source group, I have created this virtual machine, which is part of the same VNet to which I have associated the disk access through private links. And then we are going to use this same machine to perform the same action, and then we'll see what happens. So now this is the virtual machine. I have RDP'd into this virtual machine. Now we'll try to export. So because we have already generated a SAS URI from my laptop, so I have to cancel it first before I can do it again and get the SAS URI. So it will take a few seconds to cancel, and then we'll generate it again and then download. Okay. So now let's generate the SAS URI again, and then we'll try to download the data. Okay, so now if I click this, you see now I'm not getting any error message, and then I can simply save, which will basically download the underlying VSD file. So that's it. So now you can see that how you can make the export and import of managed disk very secure through private links. Thank you for watching the video, and please go over all the links that we shared during the presentation. And if you have any questions, please contact us through our MSDM forums, and we'll definitely love to answer your questions.